Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Zooty Pickups. In today's video, we'll be talking about the Nike Air Fear of God 1s in the triple black colorway. So these shoes came out April 25th of 2020 for a retail price of $350. And I believe is the 10th colorway of the Fear of God 1s to have come out. I can't believe we're already on the 10th colorway of this shoe. It just seems like yesterday these first dropped. So on this channel, I've actually done a video on these shoes before. I've done a video on the oatmeal colorway of the Fear of God 1s. And on that video, I go really in depth about like the history, the design principles, like the unboxing and stuff like that. So it's more of a deep dive video. So I figured, you know, instead of doing like another similar video, I just kind of do more or less of a colorway overview, or kind of like a light overview on the triple blacks. If you guys are interested in that deep dive video, I'm going to leave the link for the oatmeal video in the description down below. So a brief summary of the origin of this shoe is that it is a collaboration in between Fear of God's creator Jerry Lorenzo and Nike, and it's significant because it's a brand new silhouette, and usually Nike doesn't do brand new silhouettes with anyone that's not an athlete. I believe the only other non-athlete to get a Nike silhouette was Kanye, I think, and yeah, I don't think there's been anyone else. So, you know, you can definitely tell that Jerry is a fashion designer when it comes to these shoes, because they're really avant-garde, you know, they're really out there. They're pretty futuristic shoes. So this time around, for the triple black colorway, we can see that not that much has changed apart from, you know, the color of the shoe. But there are some slight differences in the accessories that come with the shoe, so I want to talk about that a little bit. So the main difference is what you get in the accessory packet here. The accessory packet has a bunch of these like lace stays, and so you have three sets of lace stays. Essentially, you have the ones that I have on the shoe here, which are kind of like a translucent black lace stay, and then you have these, which are a matte black lace stay, and then you have these kind of like I guess faded orange lace stays. So you get a set of three of these essentially, and then you get two extra sets of laces. You have a oatmeal lace, and then you have kind of like a sail off-white type of color lace here. Honestly, I don't really get why they gave us the oatmeal lace, because like, I mean, as you can see here, the oatmeal color and the black color like don't really mesh together. Maybe these are just some leftover laces from back when they did the oatmeals. I don't know. I probably won't be using these. The sail colored laces, however, are interesting. Obviously this is a triple black shoe, so using the sail laces will ruin that whole triple black kind of look, but the contrasting lace on this will kind of accent the unique lacing pattern that the shoe has here, the diamond lacing pattern. So I think the sail laces could look pretty cool on this shoe, give that like little bit of a pop of contrast there. But yeah, apart from that, I mean, the other accessories are pretty much identical to any other Fear of God 1 shoe, including the silver bags and like the hang tags and everything like that. So we will not really touch on that in this video. So I guess like speaking of triple black, I mean, you can see that the shoe is pretty much like murdered out in black. And this is kind of like I feel like it's kind of a slippery slope, because so when the shoe is one color, I feel like it can be kind of difficult to make it visually interesting. Like you run the risk of just having like this monochromatic blob that has no distinguishable features, and they could also kind of look like those, like, you know, non-slip food service worker shoes, right? So on this shoe, however, I think Jerry and crew kind of knew what they were doing, and they've infused a lot of different materials and textures into this triple black shoe to kind of like really give it a lot of visual interest. So let's kind of go over all the materials they use from top to bottom here. So the majority of the shoe right here, as you can see, is consisted of this kind of like black mesh material that it basically consists of the booty of the shoe, the most of the upper. And then as we go down, you can see it transitions into this very smooth and supple black suede. And at the edge of the suede, we have a kind of like a 3M toe guard. I mean, you guys could probably see that toe guard kind of shine in the lights I have here, but normally it's more of a matte finish, so you probably won't see it shine as much in real life. But yeah, it's pretty cool that the toe guard is 3M, gives it like that little extra bit of shine. Moving to the sides, you can see the cages are done in this matte black plastic as well, and the midsole slash outsole is also done in this matte black rubber. And I guess like the cherry on top would be this the air bubble, the air window here. The air window is done in this glossy kind of like translucent gray, and it really kind of like really pops on this overall non-reflective shoe. They did a very good job of kind of like picking what to make reflective. They only made the things that wanted to pop kind of glossy or reflective, and that is the air bubble window here, and the Nike swoosh here, the glossy Nike swoosh here on the lateral side, and of course the 3M on the toe guard here. So it definitely works with all these different materials and like the geometry in which the materials are all kind of like put together. It definitely does give the shoe a lot of visual interest. I really am particular to this diamond lacing pattern that they used on the Fear of God ones. I think it looks really cool, and of course the nylon webbing that goes down the middle of the shoe kind of breaks the this booty up, which could be also kind of boring if there wasn't anything there. But otherwise, apart from that, the outside of the shoe remains pretty much unchanged in terms of designs and features from all the other Fear of God 1 models. You have the swoosh here on the mini swoosh here on the lateral side. You have the Nike logo right under the heel. You have the Air Fear of God branding embossed under that. And of course, you have the Air Fear of God SN8329166, which was Jerry's grandpa's serial number while he was in the military. But yeah, I mean, pretty much everything remains unchanged. So let's go into the inside of the shoe and see if there's anything different in there. So the inside of the shoe, as you can see, is lined with a perforated micro suede material that's also, surprise, done in black. The perforations are supposed to help with the ventilation in conjunction with kind of like the airy mesh that they use on the outside of the shoe to help your foot breathe a little bit. And it kind of works because, I mean, the shoe is, it's still leather, right? And you're not going to get as good of ventilation as like just straight up just using mesh. But I think it helps more than not having it, I guess. On the back, you have this, I don't know what to call this, like this backstay kind of thing that's also done in a very supple leather that's also done in black with the Air Fear of God branding right there. And one interesting thing, I guess, is the removable insole here. So get this out. The removable insole here, you can see it's done in this faded orange colorway with perforations all along. And there is a reference to a Bible verse here. I talk about it in my other video, and you can see the background of it is orange, whereas the background of the oatmeal colorway here, as you can see, I can get it out. Ugh. There we go. The background is oatmeal color. So there's some minor differences here and there, but for the most part, the insole is the same. Under the insole, we have kind of like what makes the shoe so comfortable, which is the full length bed of Zoom Air that goes from pretty much the heel to the toe. So the entire underfoot of the shoe under this insole is a bed of Zoom Air. And also in conjunction with that, we have another unit of Zoom Air right under the heel, like the one that you can see inside the air bubble here. So essentially what you have is you have two layers of Zoom Air. You got a double stack of Zoom Air here in the heel, and then you have like a single stack of Zoom Air for the rest of the shoe, the front portion of the shoe. So yeah, that pretty much wraps it up on the inside. Let's move out to the outside here. As you can see, the outsole is done in all black as well. You got that ripple pattern that has now become famous for the Fear of God ones. And then you can see the pattern going out throughout the translucent gray air bubble here. And then obviously you have the Nike logo right there. So yeah, I think that pretty much summarizes all the features and design elements of the triple black Fear of God ones. As you can see, there's really not a whole lot that's different from any of the other Fear of Gods because, yeah, I mean, it's just a different colorway, right? So let's move on to the sizing and comfort portion of the shoe. So unfortunately, the sizing has remained pretty much exactly the same since the first Fear of God ones, which is like kind of weird. Like the sizing for this shoe is very odd, I think. This shoe fits very narrow and kind of like long. I think the last that they used to make this shoe was, you know, based on the perfect NBA foot, which I guess is like really narrow and long, right? So for normal people, the shoe is going to be a little long and a little too narrow, I think, in my opinion anyway. So I went true to size for my oatmeals, and these oatmeals, they had a little bit of wiggle room on the toe, but the width was way too narrow, and I it was kind of uncomfortable to wear. So I decided for the triple blacks, I should size up one size and see how they feel like. So I did size up one size, and I do have a little bit more wiggle room in the toe here, because it you know, I have a little extra length. However, the width definitely improved a little bit, making the overall fit much more pleasant and much more comfortable. So basically my advice is, if you have a wide foot, which I do, you should definitely size up half a size or a full size. And if you have a narrow foot, or I guess like even a normal-ish foot, go true to size and you should be fine. Moving to comfort, let's talk about the comfort of the shoe. So like I said early in the video, this shoe has a double layer Zoom Air system. You got double stack Zoom Air in the heel right here. That makes the shoe extremely comfortable to wear. I mean, I like, with no exaggeration, I think this is probably one of the most comfortable Nike shoes I've ever worn. The cushioning is different than what you would kind of expect from like Boost or even like React. I want to say like Boost is more of a kind of like a pillowy cloud-like cushion. React is a little more responsive than that, but it's still kind of like really pillowy. Zoom Air is really responsive. Like when you push, it like pushes right back. You can feel the rebound, and that makes sense, right? Because this is supposed to be first and foremost a performance basketball shoe. They wanted people to ball in this shoe, right? So you need that responsiveness when you're playing basketball, and Zoom Air I think was probably a great choice for that. And just like doubling that Zoom Air stack here in the heel really gives you that extended comfort. I don't know why Nike doesn't do more Zoom Air shoes. I honestly think Zoom Air is probably like one of their best cushioning technologies to date. However, there is one thing I definitely have to address when I'm talking about the comfort of this shoe. While the shoe is really comfortable to wear, it's really difficult to put on your foot, and I just can't leave that out, right? As you can see, like there's a zipper back here that you can open to get into the shoe and kind of like pull this back, stay back, but that doesn't make the opening that much bigger, as you can see. And like this micro suede material, it's like a pretty high friction material, right? So when you're putting your foot in and out, it's a struggle. It's a huge struggle. My oatmeals, which were true to size on me, those were really hard to get on and off. Like literally I would like fight with them every time I wanted to get them on and off. These I sized up one size. Another reason I sized up actually was so that they'd be easier to put on, like on it, like really. And they are actually a little easier to put on, but they're definitely still not just like shoes I can just pop on and get out of the house in like 10 seconds. I need to like sit down and really like commit to putting these shoes on. So that is kind of like a huge design failure that they can really improve upon. If they really want people to wear this shoe, you know, you don't want it to make it really hard to get in and out of the shoe. Getting out of the shoe is also like even harder than getting into the shoe, because you know, you can't really push on it, you have to pull. So yeah, I mean overall, I if like I said in my previous video, if they made this zipper opening go down a little more, or made this backstay kind of like more flexible or something like that, I think it would have helped a lot. But as it stands, I mean, it's probably the hardest shoe to get on out of like any shoe I own. So with no exaggeration, actually. So that being said, let's kind of like move on to like applicability and fits and like wearability and stuff like that. So I think a lot of people, when they buy shoes, they buy shoes that look cool by themselves. Like, you know, they see like this really like awesome looking shoe and they're like, oh, this is gonna be so sick, I'm gonna buy this shoe. And then they realize that like it's actually really difficult to actually incorporate into an outfit. And the Fear of God ones, I think, are a great example of that kind of shoe. There's been like a ton of different like crazy colorways out there. You got like that neon green, neon orange, like canary yellow, like you got these crazy colors. But the thing is, like, the shoe itself is really out there. It's like really avant-garde, you know, with like all the futuristic lines and stuff like that. So when you have a really out there shoe and a really out there color at the same time, chances are like most people, you know, are not going to be able to pull it off unless you're like, you know, Jerry Lorenzo himself. Like me, I'm like a normal ass guy. Like when I wear something like that, it just doesn't work for me, right? And I think that's where like the triple black colorway of this shoe kind of really shines, or I guess the opposite, it really subdues, right? The colorway is a really subdued kind of like almost covert colorway, and it kind of brings down that like really out there-ness of the design, because at least now it's like, you know, it's all black, so it's a lot more wearable, so it kind of like evens that out. And I think this shoe is definitely more practical than any of the other Fear of God 1 colorways out there. I mean, apart from like the black and white version, which is also pretty practical. And I think practicality is king when it comes to shoes, essentially. So I think you guys should definitely think about that when you're choosing a colorway. So all in all, I think that's pretty much everything I wanted to talk about this shoe and this colorway. You know, I have a pretty difficult decision to make now. I have to choose whether I'm gonna keep the black ones or the oatmeal ones, because I can't have two $350 shoes sitting around here. Honestly, I mean, just because of the reasons I mentioned earlier, practicality, I'm kind of leaning towards the triple blacks. But you know, tell me what you guys think. What do you guys think I should do? So yeah, let me throw these on feet so you guys can see what they look like. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments down below. And once again, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.